ladies and gentlemen, you now know that we have come into the village of Mayam. And the whole idea today is to bring to you how from this very Goan Mati comes the idol of Ganesh, which is celebrated in pomp over here in Goa and in the entire coastal region. So in Mayam, there is a ward called as the Kumbharwado. We have come to the house of the heirs of Vishnu Anand Sheth. And ladies and gentlemen, to make things more clearer to you, we all know the gentleman whose name was Mr. Anand Sheth. At one time, the speaker of the Goa Assembly. You can see behind me a beautiful tulsi. Now, this particular tulsi is always there in the front of the houses of Hindus. The reason is religious, and also because our ancestors were very, very smart. This tree that you see over here is called as Osimum Sanctum, or the Tulsi tree. And it is highly medicinal. What our ancestors wanted us to do was protect this tree, because a few leaves of this, if the children eat it, small children, they are very good deworming. If you have a sore throat, this is the tree that you look at. And after you see such a beautiful art over here, and there is another tulsi over there, you know that this is a place where you have artists. And you will be amazed. We have gone to see Ganesh Chaturthi, and I'm sure you guys have eaten Nyorios at different people's house. But the very reason that the Nyorios are made, the festivity of Ganesh Chaturthi, and the making of this Ganesh idol is an amazing art, amazing art. So we have come here to this house, lovely house over here. Let me find out whom I can grab hold of to get this information. Let's go. Wait, ladies and gentlemen. Let me just trouble my cameraman, because I have made him. He's behind the camera actually, but I have given the mic to him. Let's grab the mic from him. Okay, here it comes. Now let's see whom we can grab a hold of. Oh, I can see Amrish Sheth coming down. Amrish Bab.
Hello.
How are you?
Fourth,
sir. Amrish Bab, we are very much interested in knowing how you make the Ganesh idol. Would you take us around and show us?
That'd be my pleasure, sir.
Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's come with him and see how they make the idols. So here we come. Let Amrish lead us. And from, you know, what a little bit of talk I had with him, it's amazing. Amrish Baba, please tell me, you make this of mud. Do you get this mud in the local area here, or do you have to bring it from somewhere?
No, previously, we used to get this kind of mud at Bicholim.
Okay.
Okay, and since all that mud was all used up and got empty, so we had to go to Warkhand in Pernem.
Okay, so you get this mud now from Pernem. Any particular name for this mud?
In Konkani, we usually call it Chikatmati.
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 Okay. In other words, ladies and gentlemen, what he means, the Chikatmati, the mud from which this is come, it is called as molding clay. Normally, it would be called as molding clay. And what do you do with this mud? Do you use it directly, or do you have to mash it up properly to make it into something of your requirement? Where do you keep it?
No, in the beginning, initially, we don't have to mash it up.
Huh.
We dig the mud. We transport it using a truck.
So you dig it? Or yeah. Are there people who supply?
It's a manual work.
Okay.
It's a manual work. So first and foremost, what we do is we get the trip.
Hmm.
We transport it through truck.
Okay.
And we place it in a convenient place so that we can access it while using, before digging it up.
Okay.
Before meshing it up.
Okay.
And we wait for the rains to
arrive. How do you mesh it? Do you all have machines or do you all use your hands or the legs?
No, this is a manual work and we usually do it through legs.
Through the legs.
Yeah.
Ha, ladies and gentlemen, so now here is another part where you put your legs to use. The first one I showed you was mashing up the beautiful cashew fruit to make the feni. And now from feni, we are going directly to a spiritual end where they make the idols. So where do you keep this mud? Is this the mud?
This is the mud.
Okay, this is the mud.
So after getting transported,
okay,
we keep it at a very convenient place so that we can access it easily.
Okay.
Okay, this is the place where we can have a good access out of it.
Hmm.
And then we take it inside so that it can be meshed up with the help of legs.
Okay, so it becomes very nice and fine for molding.
Fine, yeah.
Okay, what is this place where you make these idols called?
It's normally called a workshop or Kokani jar sangpal. If we call it in Kokani, we call it Chitrashala.
Chitrashala. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, when any pottery molding work is happening, we normally use the term workshop. Now, workshop becomes a very technical word. But in Goa, Amcha Goyan, we call it Chitrashala or Ganpatichi Shala or the school of Ganesh. Did Ganesh go to school? I think we are learning from him. Well, but they still call it Chitrashala or art school. Am I right?
Exactly.
Okay. So now let us go and see the Chitrashala. Ladies and gentlemen, see, look at the protocol that has to be followed. When you enter somebody's house, you normally don't walk inside with your footwear. So also, when we walk inside this Chitrashala or the place where they make the Ganesh, we leave our footwear outside because the footwear brings in a lot of dust and dirt from the entire village side since we are in the village. And you know, in the village, we have a lot of cows and you know what they do. So sometimes we are forced to carry that inside. So we leave our slipper shoes over here. And now let us enter the Chitrashala. Let's follow Amrish in the Chitrashala. First, Amrish Bab, can you just show us somebody who is mashing up this mud that we saw outside?
So we have our workers over here who would with full dedication,
yes,
they put up themselves into this and mash this clay or this mud so much so that it can be conveniently used for making Ganesh idols.
Are there any specialists who are involved or anybody can do this?
In fact, anybody can do this. They just need proper guidance.
Okay.
From the ones who have already done this before.
Okay.
It's not a difficult task. It can be done easily.
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, nothing is difficult in this world. All you got to use are your hands and your brains. And like he said, this has been the tradition, the custom in India or in the Indian culture where the art and the literature and the knowledge passes from the grandfather to the father, from the father to the son, and from the son to his sons. So this is something that we will see for ourselves. And now please don't go out in the mud and start meshing up whichever mud you get. This is special mud. I have seen Ajit squashing that mud and I remembered my childhood. Can I also pick up a small piece of mud and try my hand at doing something?
Of course, why not? Let's get back to nostalgia.
Oh yes, now that is a beautiful word that he has used, nostalgia. I'm sure if you were young and if you have ever seen this type of things happening in your villages, These memories must and will come up. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so happy amongst all these elders who are working here, I see somebody from the new generation. Now this generation is going to carry the memories. You can see he's already set, and he is going to carry these memories into the decades and the years to come. Tujhe naam kya hai?
Vishnu.
I am actually talking to Vishnu himself, that is Lord Vishnu himself, in the company of Lord Ganesh. Whoops. So now I'm going to try my hand at mud molding. I'll ask my cameraman to hold my mic back again. This is sticky. This is very sticky. What can I make of this? Yeah, I think I made my profile. See this. I got a big nose, hair, and my eye too. Well, I can try my hand at molding. Amrish Bab, I think next year I'm going to join you in doing all this. Now that this mud has been mashed up and got into the right tone which is required, let us see what happens with this mud. Now here we have got Mr. Durgaram Sheth, who is doing something in a mold made out of cement or plaster of Paris. Let's find out what he is doing. Durgaram Bab, kasha asa? Ti mati kadun tumi kire karta thanga?
Plaster of Paris mold asa. Ani jo amka jar ganpati tayar karpak layo.
Hai.
Jale he moldan amka ti
म्हणजे हे आमकां जे गणपतीचे रूप दिसता ते मोल्डान प्रेस करून तयार करतात. पूण हाज्या पयली म्हणजे आमचे जे पयली पूर्वज आशिल्ले ते तेन्ना प्लास्टर ऑफ पॅरीस नाशिल्लो. तेन्ना ते कशे करताले गणपती? सगळे हातान
करताले किंवा सिमेंटचे मोल्ड करताले.
सिमेंटचे मोल्ड करताले तेन्ना.
आमगेर सुद्धा 20-25 सिमेंटचे मोल्ड
आसा.
बापायन केल्ले आसा.
हा हा हा.
ते यूज करता.
ही कला तुम्ही कोणाकडसून शिकले?
बापायकडसून.
बापायकडसून. ही जी आता कार्यशाळा आसा आमची गणपतीची शाळा, चित्रशाळा आसा, ती सुरू कोण केली?
म्हणजे बापायन.
तांचे नाव?
विष्णू अनंत शेठ.
विष्णू अनंत शेठ. म्हणजे आमकां जो आता लहान विष्णू अनंत शेठ मेळ्ळा ताजो आजो.
तेजो आजो.
विष्णू कालिदास शेठ. दॅट यंग फेलो which you may at one time, if you come to Goa and attend Ganesh Chaturthi, somewhere after another 10, 15, 20 years, you may get an idol made by Mr. Vishnu Sheth. Can you believe it? This is Goa. Right from the white hair that you see here to this generation that you see here, we are all involved in preserving the culture of Goa. Ladies and gentlemen, wherever you may be in the US, you may be in the UK, you may be in Portugal, you may be in Australia, you may be anywhere else in India. Please preserve the culture of Goa in whatever way you want. So Durgaram Bab has told us how they start putting that mud into a mold. But now I saw something else here, a bigger mold. One we saw was smaller. Let us find out from Ajit Bab here. Ajit Bab, kine karta tu?
Mati
laita. Ante bharun katta sagale. Hi ata fude ka hi fat.
Hi
fat. Ajit is a little shy to be on the camera, but what he is trying to tell us is that he is putting the mud and creating a backdrop for the idol. The idol front is on the other side in this mold. This is how a mold looks like. Also help?
Of course they do. They actually have a major role in this. It's not that only males have their part in making the
idol.
Entire idol, but women actively participate and contributing to its major part.
Making or the painting part?
Everything.
Everything. Yeah. Okay. So we have any ladies doing this thing here?
Yes.
Okay, let's go and see them. So Amrish just brought us to another section here where they are making, where the ladies are doing this. So now I'm going to ask Amrish to introduce us to these ladies who are artists par excellence. Amrish Bab, yes, can you please tell us who the ladies are and what they are doing right now?
Here's my mother, Srimati Anuradha Anand Sheth. Okay. As you can see, she is forming up.
Giving the finishing touches.
Yeah, giving the finishing touches. As you can see, the entire idol has been made. And only the minor, the internal shaping up.
Okay. Tell me one thing. You know, normally the ladies, they love ornaments and all. So do the ladies do the ornament work in this, or it is done by the mold?
That is included. That is the part of the entire making of an idol.
Okay.
So it's not a separate part that we need a specialized person or somebody else.
It becomes part of that.
It becomes a part of
that. Okay. Okay. And this other lady, she seems to be beating the hand. Why is that?
It's for the grip.
Okay.
Okay. As you can see, the hand is the completely separate part of the idol.
Okay.
So it has to be, it has a separate mold which has to be taken out and then joined it. So that the beating up.
The both the parts have to be rough to join one another.
So that it holds up a grip of the other part.
Perfect. So this part which, you know, the hand is being fixed to the main idol. This lady, we did not get her introduction. Can you please tell us who she is?
Yeah, she is my kaki. Her name is Srimati Priya Premendra Sheth.
Okay. And she also has been helping you all put the hands up?
Extensively.
Okay. Now that we are on the hand, let me ask you. You have introduced us to your mother.
Yeah.
Okay, now you have introduced us to your kaki.
Yeah.
And your kaki is doing something to fix the hand.
Yeah.
Do you remember your mother using this hand on you any time earlier?
Lot of time.
Wow. Okay.
Without that, I wouldn't have been the person I am right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is what you call the culture of Goa. Respect for the elders, respect for your mother, and respect for that smack that he must have got here or here, which he realizes that today he is a man because of this. So next time, I don't know the laws of your country, but if you need to use this hand, use it. It's not an advice, just an opinion. It worked with us, our generation. And I'm sure many of you remember the fingerprints on all of you. But let's come back to the hand of the Ganesh idol. We have seen the elders, we have seen the mothers, the ladies working on different things. And here you can see the finished product, the idols, which have been kept for drying. And when they dry up, they are going to be painted. Now, the elder generation, they have done this. And what are they doing about carrying it forward down to the next generation? Ladies and gentlemen, here we have an artist, Vishnu Kalidas Sheth. Vishnu Bab, tu kire karta? Ganapati cha bhangar karta. Okay, now he has been sitting here with a mold which I can see is different ornaments. Tu kone shikaile hai karpak? Kone shikaile? Baban shikaile tuka. Ani? अशें मातयेन बितयेन खेळून घेतकच तुका आई बी मानना ना अशें हाताक बिताक माती लागतकच आमकां मारताली मरे तुका मानना ओके आनी आतां कितें केलां तुवें आतां कितें केलां दाखय म्हाका पळया दाखय पळया हाताचेर दवर म्हज्या कित्यान कितें केलां लेडीज एंड जेंटलमॅन कॅन यू बिलीव दीस स्मॉल जेंटलमॅन ओवर हियर ही हॅज मेड an ornament which is going to be used on the idol. Now this is something of value. This is values that are being carried down the generations from the parent, and he has been so kind enough to give credit to his learning to his father. So if you know some art, let it go down to the next generation, because I don't have words that will measure the appreciation of this young man who wants his ornament back. He seems to be grabbing it from my hand. Before I show this to you all, ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you one thing. In the Hindu pantheon of the deities and gods that we have, each of the god has his own transport vehicle. And if you think that they are four-wheelers and two-wheelers, no. They are either winged or they have a tail. And here, the official transport vehicle of Lord Ganesh is the rat. And what Vishnu Bab has made is a fabulous rat. I am confident now that the generation of today, the artists of today, the artisans of today are doing their bit of work to carry this art down to this generation. My salutes to all the artists, and my salute to this gentleman who has made this small little rat. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, many a times when we are in our professions, we always give that excuse that, I don't have the time, I have been so tired. But when it comes to an art in Goa, a traditional art in Goa, and where everybody participates, here there is another limits that have been set by the ladies. Now, I have met a lady by name Anuradha Sheth. Now, she is working as a nurse. And what is she doing also in her pastime? In the part-time that she has? She does idols. Let's meet Mrs. Sheth. Anuradha Bhai, welcome to my program called as My Goyen. I heard that you are a nurse.
Yes, I'm working in a Goa Medical College as a ward in charge, assistant ward in charge.
You're working as an assistant ward in charge. That's a big responsibility. And when you have got free time, you do these idols.
Yes.
Okay, can you show us your idol which you have made?
Yeah, these are the idols.
These two idols have been made. And some more also. Wow. Did you learn this at some time in life, or was this, has this been as a childhood? You have learned all these things from your child?
From my daddy.
From your daddy. What is his name?
Krishna Shankar Harmalkar.
Krishna Shankar Harmalkar.
From Bicholi.
From Bicholi.
He was a big artist.
In fact, ladies and gentlemen, I must tell you, Bicholim is the hub of pottery items, terracotta items. And she comes from the family of Harmalkar. We have heard the Jilu name Harmalkar. Jilu Harmalkar.
My uncle.
Jilu Harmalkar is a name which is known not only in Goa but all over India. And that happens to be her uncle.
My uncle and my father-in-law's sister's son is.
Wow.
Yeah, he's from the
that's a big connection. All connections. So in Goa, even if we are not connected by blood, Goans are connected by the heart. And that is why we are connecting all of you all. We are connecting it to you wherever you are in the world through our heart. This is My Goyen. This is what makes our heart beat. So next time you come into Goa, please search for people like this, because these are people who are carrying on the art of Goa in the generations yet to come. Thank you, Anuradha Bhai. Thank you so much for being with us.